I'm actually speechless. You walk past stuff like this all the time without even realising it's there. And she lives here.
If ever there was a more unpromising space to convert into a home, this is surely it.
Welcome.
Welcome to the toilets. That's amazingly light, isn't it?
It is. It's one of the first things I noticed. Even though when I first came down, these were all broken and covered up, you could kind of get a feel that it was actually very light, considering we're 8 foot underground and surrounded by 300 mil of concrete.
Just 12 months ago, it was all a very different picture. 9 skip loads were used to clear nearly 100 tons of concrete and rubbish. It took 2 days to just break through the doorway between the ladies' and the gents' toilets. Laura has somehow managed to create over 500 square feet of habitable space.
I was expecting it to feel kind of dingy and claustrophobic.
A bit damp, smelling of wee.
Yeah.
This is where those stalls were, with the graffiti in the beer can.
Oh, that was here then?
Yeah, so those
were the big doors here, the gents' loos.
Yeah.
I would have been propped nicely
exactly.
About that.
Exactly. Right there.
Can't believe I've just done that.
Laura has created this stylish house with lounge, kitchen, bathroom and bedroom, all 8 feet below the bustling street above.
I think that's really cool as well. It's just once in a while you see people walking over the top. You just get that little shadow cast across and see the inside of their feet.
Little bird's feet, you can see.
Little bird's feet, that'd be cute.
And
that's
the bus stop's just down there, so you often get people running for their bus.
Laura has used the classic design tricks of a white palette for the walls and reflective surfaces that help bounce the light around the space. The kitchen is where the gents' urinals used to be.
So I kept the original tiles as a splashback with all the...
See, even just the normal phrase of saying a splashback, saying that in a toilet to me makes me feel a bit sick. Normally, in any other domestic normal house, you'd go, yeah, that's a splashback. When you said that, I'm like, oh, my God, I'm going to throw up.
Are you having a little smell?
It doesn't smell of wee.
Laura's 500-square-foot house is small but perfectly formed and, fittingly, has a rather grand bathroom. Her design is making every inch of space work.
Do you want a hand? What am I doing?
Yeah, that'd be great.
Turn it this way?
Yep. My husband plays guitars.
He just sits on there, plays guitar.
You can sit in, you can put your laptop in the little space.
That is brilliant.
Close the curtain. You could be anywhere.
Half bed cave, half recording studio for a guitarist.